Hi, everyone. I'm Iddo, 40 years old, a couple of days ago, changed the number. I'm an interdisciplinary artist. I have a BA in architecture and an MA from Central St. Martin's in performance design and practice. I used to do a bit of acting. I do some video art. I mix it all up, and you'll see it here. And this talk, this theme is about change. So I'm going to talk about the changes that I had through my life. I just want to say that... this thing, this logo, this my friend Dita Maraz, who does branding. So, I'm gonna start. Okay. So, when I was a kid, I was. Very, 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 very shy. And I had, tell me if you can't hear me, because I'm shy, I usually talk very soft. So when I was a kid, I was very, very shy. And I remember I would used to dive into the swimming pool and there by myself create my own world, my own fantasy space, because I would feel like people are getting into my space when they talk to me. I mean, not getting into my space, but I couldn't find myself. So I would dive into the swimming pool and do all my fantasies and fight dragons in the swimming pool. And I was very, very shy. And then only in ninth grade, there was this girl that I really, really liked. And she told me she liked me, but I couldn't talk with her. And only through drama school, when I was another character, I was able to talk to her. So that's where I fell in love with acting and performance. After my military service, I went to travel in India. I wanted to go study acting in New York, but while being in India, I took a motorcycle, and then I had this accident. Rob, can you see me when I was, yeah? Okay. Yeah, this means press the button, okay? And volume?
Apologies, technical difficulties.
Okay.
Apologies to you. Yeah.
Okay, so I'll continue meanwhile. So I had a motorcycle accident in India. A bus hit me. Good. Cool. Oh, yeah. Okay, a bit less effective, but okay. I had a motorcycle accident in India, which left me paralyzed. From the chest down. So this is where I stop having full sense of my body. this is about the line where I can move my body, move my muscles. So I was moved there to a local hospital, and from there I flew back to Israel, and I found myself in another hospital, and I found myself with a new way to organize my body. This is a change that doesn't come instantly, because it takes time to acknowledge it. It takes time to press it. Okay. It takes time to acknowledge it, and you're in denial, and you're on a lot of drugs because of India, because of the hospital, and it takes time. But then, when I was in the hospital, I forget. I asked the doctor, doctor, will I ever walk again? And he said, quite like very objectively and without too much feeling, no. And that's when it hit me that things are going to change from now on. And the way I'm gonna appreciate space, my own body, and and the way I connect with people, it's going to be different. And I need to get used to that, to this new way of using my body and connecting to space. In performance art, the body is a site. It's like architecture. You can use the body to define your identity and can you lay it on the chair? So, in performance art, the body is used to, just lay it like that. Thank you. The body is used to to define politics and to define the way sorry. always happens. So I'm not too nervous about it. This doesn't. So you can press A. So it's not just getting used to the body changing. It's getting used to being with this, with the wheelchair. Using technology, connecting to something which is external. I'll put this on. I won't move a lot. So, connected to something which is external and coping with the notion that now you are crippled or disabled. But as Linton defined it now in disability studies, disability is not just physical, it's also social. And it's about how society defines you. So if you can redefine yourself, you can redefine disability. Okay, can you press it? So, okay. In my art, I use a lot of video art like that through the performance or the theater. This is called Theater of Cruelty, which Antonin Artaud named it. He was a surrealist. And it's a way to make, he wanted to break traditional theater and he wanted to connect to the audience. So this is a way for you to go inside my inner world, to my feelings, connect. It's about saying that language isn't sufficient enough. Language is too much going by the norms and only by very broken sound or body language, you can really connect. So this is one of the layers I do in my work. Okay, so I want to do this fast. So press A. So after my injury, the first thing I saw myself, this was for my architecture school, I did a portfolio. I saw myself as a victim, but on the other hand, I wanted to have some kind of a calling, so Jesus or whatever. This happened for me for a reason. That was the first thought. Okay. The other thought is the social thing, what I told you about, where I am with other people, how I feel about it. But then I wanted to continue traveling. I went to Central America. And you can keep on traveling and be like this fighter, I can do it all. Press it again. But I have this inner world, which is there, and my art is about connecting that ideal world with the virtual world, the two things together. Okay. Then I was a rebel, did all kinds of events with Dagnacha to everyone, with the logo, which I'm disabled and sexy, acknowledging, because a lot of people says, oh, you're disabled and you need to acknowledge. I am acknowledged I'm disabled, but I'm also sexy. I'm continuing to live on. You can press again. I studied architecture. I'm not going to go a lot into that, although it had a very big impact on me. Abstract notions of space and how space, our architecture is, sorry for giving you my back, is an authority. So you can organize people in the way you want, organize relations, like everything, like a court puts the judge up and the what you call it? Defend it down, a museum, whatever. And I like Dutch architecture, which tries to play with the program. That's what interests me. More than aesthetics, it's the social element. Okay. That brought me up to do the disabled and sexy fashion show. This is not me. Probably a lot of people came because they saw this pic. I don't know. But that's not me. That's Oni, who joined me, and Talia, who also joined me. And we did this in Tel Aviv Dome with 15 top Israeli designers, all volunteer. And you can press it, and I'll shut up for a while.
נחה וסקסי, נחה וסקסי. זו הכותרת של אחת מתצוגות האופנה היותר מיוחדות שהתקיימו בתל אביב. כתבנו אורי מסגב היה בתצוגה ששמה את כיסאות הגלגלים על המסלול.
אנחנו נתחיל עכשיו באיזה חזרה קלה. תוך כדי אנחנו נמשור אתכם לאיפור בשיער.
ראינו שלא מגיעים, לא מגיעים נכים לטלוויזיה, לא רואים אותם בתוכניות ריאליטי, לא רואים אותם בתוכניות גם לא ריאליטי. ואז אנחנו אומרים, מה הבעיה פה? איפה המכשול? והמכשול הוא המבוכה והוא הכיסא.
בואו נמשיך לעבוד.
שלושה צעירים נכים קמים בוקר אחד ומחליטים לעשות מעשה. הם בוחרים דווקא בתחום שבימים רגילים לא מאמץ אליו בחום פרוטזות וכיסאות גלגלים. עולם הזוהר.
אני יודע שעל נכה מסתכלים בדיוק כמו על סלבריטאי. יש כאילו קליטה ראשונית ואיזשהו דימוי. וגם הסלבריטאי מצד אחד יש לו הרבה יותר ממשהו, וגם הנכה או הדוגמן.
מה שהתחיל לפני שבעה חודשים כחלום הזוי משהו, הפך בסוף השבוע האחרון לעובדה קיימת. תצוגת אופנה שבה משתפים פעולה על המסלול נכים ודוגמניות מקצועיות. מילת המפתח הייתה אינטראקציה.
נכים הם לא קבוצה, ובכלל אני לא אוהב קבוצות של אנשים. כל בן אדם הוא אינדיבידואל עם הרצונות שלו והשאיפות שלו והחלומות שלו. והיום תהיה נהדר דווקא בגלל הדוגמנים הבריאים, ודווקא בגלל שגם להם תינתן הזדמנות לא ללכת שוב הלוך חזור על המסלול כמו איזה דמות.
That was in 2004. 11 years after that they did in the UK something with the same name. And it... Okay, press. Okay, so it was great and people loved it, but my thing is, this is for example Kate, which is blind, and they put her in very nice clothes, it's very, has a big impact, colors, but what does this say? I'm blind, but I can wear colors. Okay, and press A again. And this is Shlomi, this is, I like this one, but it's an amputee, and this says, oh, I'm cool like him, and I'm even cooler, I'm a pirate, and it's cool. But, press A, what I wanted to do, and it couldn't be done because it was a volunteer and because people were not probably ready for it, is take it a step forward. If I'm blind, this is a blind photographer who takes a picture and then draws the people on the people with light. If I'm blind, let fashion be blind. Let's say fashion doesn't have to be about seeing. It could be about hearing the clothes, smelling the clothes, feeling it. Let it be dark when there's a fashion, and let us hear, sense it. If it's an amputee, let fashion be not about, let it about where technology meets the body, where technology is clothing already. Do we need clothes with all the technology? So that's how you make disability not just bring it up to the norms. Oh, I can be like you. It's having that experience of being disabled and having another perspective change society. So that's what I want to do. I was in a TV series. And there, usually a disabled person, and that's what I was there, does drugs and doesn't want to be disabled anymore, which is kind of true, but still we're proud of what we are and who we are with this disability. So this did Chaim Buzaglo, which I like very much, but it's another notion that I wanted to change. This is another way of the, I was in New York documenting. This is when someone young does it, already more open to disability, and she wants to show me before the disability.
Hi, my name is Iddo. I'm a guy in a wheelchair. 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 I came here from Israel 2 months ago. I really love New York. It's fun. You can be whatever you want here. It doesn't matter if you're different. Just you can be yourself. You can let go. And that's why I came here, because I came here to let go, to express myself. I want people to see me, to see the man, not the wheelchair. I'm a man in a wheelchair, but the wheelchair is not all I am about. I'm a human being like everyone, and I have my dreams, I have my inspirations, I have my bad things, my good things, and that's who I am. And you know, like Red Chili, Hot Chili Pepper said, I am what I am, most motherfuckers don't give a damn, you know. So the thing is, though, that when I go in the streets, there are nice people, of course, but there's also a lot of people, like a type of people, that either get so embarrassed from the wheelchair and they walk away or pull away. They give you so much space, too much space, and or there are people who would smile politely, but you see that they don't know what to do with themselves. And the people who will just try to ignore. And I don't understand that. There's a lot of things that they think they're the biggest obstacles or things, but I can, like, for example, stairs. People think that, oh my God, there's stairs, what is he going to do? But you deal with that, you deal with life, like you're going to take a hike on, I don't know, on the mountains. I deal with that. So I deal with the stairs, I go down the stairs, I go up the stairs. That's not the issue. That's not the main issue. The main issue is the reaction of people and what the fuck, I mean, what the fuck, you know? So I want to be an actor. I want to be a director. I've got a lot of things to say. And what I really want to direct is stage. Because I prefer dealing with actors and feelings and less with technique stuff. I really want to go deep and check out people and see how those feelings base all our lives. And I think that there's change all the time, and it comes out of wants and loves. And for example, I did the fashion show, which I called in Israel Disabled and Sexy, or you can call that Disabled Body. And it it's 15 models, disabled models, with 15 normal models. Because of what I had, the accident I had 9 years ago, I see things with a better perspective. I see things more clearly. I see things. It's not that I don't experience life and all the minor things, but I know what it is to survive. I know what it is to be different. I know what it is to what's the basic needs of the heart, of the man. I live one life. I'm going on. And if you don't like the heat, get the fuck off my street. What's up?
A change, and the impact I want to make is through connection like this, which is very frontal, but also connected to space, connected to how I conceive space and my inner world, which I use video art to do it.
Oh my God.
Sorry for So now how I move in space. Can you connect it? Because I'm just... Okay. Okay. So, can you press it? Okay. So then I got married to my beautiful wife, Michal. And can you press it again? And we build our house, which is about connecting, seeing things through different ergonometrics and different ways of using the body, and something more holistic. And then, press again. And then we had our kids, which is amazing. Because of the disability, it was in IVF procedures, but I talk to my friends and I think about 50%, 30%, I don't know, having this, having procedures. And that brought me into my mind that we are all, not just because of disability, we are all getting immersed with technology. I mean, something like sex and birth is connected to technology. We're everyone is with this. With this, I can just. We're all. Right? We're like this, actually. We're connected all the time. Can you press it? So these are my beautiful kids, Raya and Hanan. And then we went to London. Okay, press it. I came to London in 2012. It was an utopia for me. It was the Paralympics. Everything, people like the Paralympics more than the Olympics. I heard people talk. They said they could connect more. Everything was around it. Everything, whoever was in London, was commercials about disability. The train was full with commercial. TV was only Paralympics. The news, the newspaper, Paralympics. This is the first way to rehabilitate through sports and through our body. And that's what people with disability first stage is. Okay. Okay. This is the first stage. It's really important to do sports. For me, it wasn't enough, and I think as society and for disabled person, it's not enough, because there's another thing which is about expressing yourself, and this is where disability art comes into. Disability arts in London, in England, is funded. Fund a lot, okay? You can see people with disabilities like Lisa Bufano, Sue Austin, they challenge space, they challenge the notion of space, they challenge the notion of disability, and this is thought the new avant-garde, and it is, and after this, I think it will be about age, and this will be the next thing. It's just the next minority who's bringing something new to society. Can you press it again? And you have this kind of things. This is not a creep show anymore. Like when I did my fashion show, the producer said, well, it's going to be a creep show. It's not. Because a creep show is when they take like a dwarf or someone like me and they said, oh, look at him, he's so small. But this is when you take authority, when you decide what's the meaning for you, he decides, they decide, then it's not a creep show. It's expressing yourself through your body. Okay, next. Okay, so my first thing I did was to, when I was in Central St. Martin's, who won first building in London, a very beautiful building, but it was not accessible. I couldn't go to the library. So I used the, I did a site-specific performance. I used the cage a lot, you see it later. And that's or 510. Okay. Okay, so press A. So, just as Bernard Sumi, architect, says, there's architecture, the concept of architecture, The concept of space is not space. Architecture only works when you things are living in it. And site-specific takes you away from the space to think about it in a new nature. So that's, and with, when it comes with disability, it's about that. Press A. Okay. This is a theater show. I used, this I showed how theater can become a performance, how you can, can you press Z, please? Okay, I'm going to jump on that, I think, but just for later. It's on theater, I play a character, and you're there, I'm here. This is a thing that I worked on where I took a classic play by Pinter, and it's the players do it once in repetition. They do it once. Classic. It's about a couple that talks about the first time they went out. Each one remembers a different thing. And then they start blaming each other that they cheated on each other. So the first time I do it like that. The second time, they start bringing people from the audience in, and they talk about their memories. They do it with them. And then the third time, they start activating the audience, and the audience starts doing those memories. And the last time, the audience already has projections, and they do it themselves. And the two actors sit. It's like you're all going to be here, and I'm going to sit here. And then they and I left the building. They leave the building. So like the couples see how they made their inner world. That's what I talked about, inner world and outer world. How their inner world comes alive through the audience. And the audience makes the scenography, because there's nothing besides that. And I used the video art at the beginning to get them into there. There's two empty swings in the snow. But there's not a lot of time, so I want to show the last. I'm not going to talk about it a lot. This is the last piece that you'll understand from all my life. That's what I did there, metamorphosing. I took Kafka's Metamorphosis, the story that Gregor becomes an insect, a vermin. It starts with that Gregor woke up one day and saw he's a vermin. Just like I woke up in the hospital and saw I'm disabled. And it goes parallel, and I use it. Can you press A again? And again? Again? So at the beginning, I did everything in the middle, and people around it, and projections here and here. This was very, very confusing. So instead, I used, in order to get people connected to me. It's about me, my wife having the birth, and about Gregor becoming an insect through technology. So instead of that, I put me here and the audience, so this performance, this connection, which is real. Then this place is reality, like playing reality, my wife, me, and the doctor. And then here a video, which is more about the atmosphere. And then a big net, and here is that my inner world, which is Gregor becoming an insect, and a video art about my feelings. And the doctor and the woman cross side, the woman becomes his sister, the doctor becomes his boss, and Gregor and me connect. And then in the middle, I fight Gregor, because Gregor dies from despair, and I want to beat the classic thing. So I use classic things to help me connect to people and then break it. So please press A. And that's it. I'm not going to talk anymore. This is about 8 minutes, okay? And that's, and after that, if you want, you can ask me questions.
Welcome. May I remind you all to switch on your phones but turn the sound off. Thank you very much.
Grab the customer.
If you want to be number one, You must break yourself to do this. Do you understand? Perfect, Mr. Samson. Perfect.
As my brother Gregor Samson awoke one morning from uneasy dreams, he found himself transformed in his bed into a gigantic insect. His numerous...
Doctor, will I ever walk again?
No!
What?
Ethan had an accident!
Oh my god! Hello? Talk slow. Start from the beginning. Well, how is he now?
What?
Ethan had an accident!
Oh my god! Hello? Talk slow. Start from the beginning. Well, how is he now? Are you sure? Did you call the insurance? Oh my god. Yes, give me your contact details.
Get rid of it.
I bet I'll take it.
What are you doing?
Get the Technology and live on.